Let's talk to Dr. Paul Stott about this. He's research fellow, Middle East analyst at the Henry Jackson Society. Good morning to you, Paul.
Good morning.
Good morning. Now, of course, I mean, these accusations have been flooding thick and fast almost since the earliest days when Jamal Khashoggi disappeared. How significant is it that there's a UN special rapporteur report, given that we've had those sort of rapporteur reports on things like British poverty and the like in the UK, and frankly, they've been given short shrift?
Well, that's why those types of frivolous reports and needless interventions by the UN are damaging and damage the UN's brand, because here you actually have, from Agnes Callamard, the special rapporteur, a very substantive document that I think 99.5% proves the case against the Saudis and shows their responsibility in Khashoggi's murder.
I mean, this is it. In terms of, you know, the people have always been pointing the finger, and the fact that some of the people who were caught on CCTV, the airport arriving the day before he was murdered and disappeared and leaving the next day, some of the closest security aides to the Crown Prince. But even if the finger is pointing with this much evidence behind it, does that change? Is anything going to happen? I mean, the UN doesn't have any criminal prosecutorial powers. The International Criminal Court, well, Saudi Arabia's not signed up to it. And let's face it, the overweening fact here, Saudi Arabia's got a lot of oil. Is anything going to happen?
Well, I think there's six breaches of international law that Agnes Callamard sets out, but I'm afraid I rather share your cynicism. This is really, I think, right from the start, been a story that's caught up in the power play between Turkey and Qatar on one side, Saudi Arabia and its allies on the other. And it's also worth stressing the Saudis have been getting away with this sort of thing for some years. There have been a whole series of kidnappings from Europe of dissident Saudi princes, members of the royal family who are considered black sheep. And this is something in a way slightly similar. It's just more brutal.
Indeed. Can I also ask you about the developments today? We've seen on the Gulf of Oman with the revelation that an American military drone has been shot down by the Iranian Revolutionary Guard. This is all upscaling of tensions that we've seen after those attacks on those tankers in the Gulf of Oman. Of course, one of the busiest straits in the world, with a huge amount of the world's oil travels through there. Americans blame the Iranians for those attacks. The tensions are certainly mounting. The Iranians say that drone was shot down over their airspace. Americans say over international airspace. This is a huge ratcheting up of tensions. How concerned are you that we could be heading towards some sort of military conflict there?
Well, we seem to be inching towards it. I mean, it'll be interesting to see later today if either side produces definitive evidence of where this drone was. But certainly, I think the Iranians have been wounded by the Americans producing evidence from one of their planes. If you remember, what appeared to be people removing a mine from one of the ships that had been attacked recently. I think we're in a very dangerous situation. And again, this is the sort of area where you might expect the United Nations to be taking a lead. It wasn't even able to reach a position on the attack on the four ships in the United Arab Emirates last month. So we're not in a good position, and every development seems to be moving in a slightly worse direction.
But certainly there are, I mean, the hawks in the White House. I mean, this would be exactly the evidence that they could use as an excuse for some further escalation.
I think the Americans are in a pretty robust mood at the moment. What we don't know is, obviously, some of the press speculation seems to slightly divide John Bolton as being more aggressive than Trump. That remains to be seen. But, you know, if the Iranians are shooting down American drones, the next fear on the American side is, you know, next time, will it be a plane?
OK, thank you very much indeed, Dr. Paul Stott, their research fellow, Middle East analyst at the Henry Jackson Society.